today. From NRG Stadium in Houston, Texas. It's week one of the NFL on EA Sports. See Davis Mills and the Houston Texans taking on Matt Ryan and the Indianapolis Colts.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Today we jump right into this new season with an AFC South matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Houston Texans. Welcome to the start of another NFL season, joined by Charles Davis in the booth. I'm Brandon Gauden, and partner, it's always great to begin another year. It's especially great when you get to see a couple of division rivals square off right out of the gate, and that's what we're going to see here in the Indianapolis Colts and the Houston Texans.
And I know people get tired of it sometimes because we always zero in on the quarterback position, but I don't think we can avoid it here with these two teams in the AFC South. How about in Indianapolis? Matt Ryan, now their quarterback. Can he get them on a postseason run? Because he is the team's sixth week one starter in six seasons, and Indy hasn't won its opener since 2013. And Houston, Deshaun Watson officially gone. Davis Mills took over last year. Can he improve on a 4-13 record? I like his chances.
As the Texans' offense runs out, we get a peek at the man under center, second-year quarterback Davis Mills out of Stanford.
I think when we really analyze the 2021 NFL season, Houston Texans quarterback Davis Mills, he deserves a lot more credit than he got for leading a bad team last season. Circumstances led the third-round rookie to being thrown in as the team starter, and he really came on after some early struggles. Four 300-yard games from him, and he led Houston to a big upset of the Chargers to help keep L.A. out of the playoffs.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. They'll go again here with Mack, and he'll take this to the 32, a gain of about three. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Finds his man. It's John Metchie. The 30. And they're going to be set up now with the ball at the 13-yard line. That was so well timed. Just a perfect throw on the slant.
Hit him on the move, didn't he? Now he's going against the grain of the defenders coming over to try and stop him. That allowed for that additional yardage downfield.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. A first down throw for Mills. This is caught. And the Texans are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Mack. Trying to get to the goal line, but he's going to be stopped just short at the 1. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Here's where we need to see some tenacity from this defense because they've been pushed right down the field on this opening drive. They've got to find some way to push back, and that's a good first step.
Mack again, and he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Marlon Mack, his first rushing touchdown on the year, and the Texans are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. So the drive there took 6 plays. And the end result was a Marlon Mack touchdown run. Out is the Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. Bringing it out of his end zone, Isaiah Rodgers. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Out onto the field comes the Colts offense for their first series, and at quarterback, a new name this year to the franchise, of course, but certainly not new to the league, a 15-year vet, former league MVP, Matt Ryan.
In a storied career that has spanned 14 seasons and nearly 60,000 yards through the air, we're seeing a brand new chapter for Matt Ryan this year. With Atlanta in a rebuild, Ryan was dealt to Indianapolis, who is their sixth week one quarterback in six seasons. One of the most decorated quarterbacks still active, this move will keep Ryan on a contender as he chases his first career Super Bowl title.
The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
That was good, tough running right up the middle, and if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Back to Taylor on first down. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Jerry Hughes on the stop. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 33. He got 29 yards that time.
Love the play call that time. Love the design. You put three tight ends on the field, that screams jumbo set, running formation to a defense, right? No, they go play action and defense gets confused for just a split second. And next thing you know, completion for good yardage.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory, down at the 33. And he'll take this ahead for about four, second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
His throw caught right around the six. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. They'll run here with Taylor. And he gets halfway there from the six to the three on a gain of three.
Jonathan Taylor, a touchdown machine. He's going to get plenty of looks down here near the goal line, so if I'm on defense, I might start getting prepared to see his number called a couple more times.
Again, it'll be Taylor. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor, a three-yard touchdown run. And the Colts are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Well, first quarter, maybe too early to talk about statement drives, Charles, but that sure seemed like a statement drive right there.
Well, if we're going to talk about statement drives, I think what they're saying is we're going to establish the run. They gave it to him early and often on this drive, and he wound up taking it into the end zone.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and we are tied at seven. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, had he opted for the touchback. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little. Injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
The Houston Texans were looking to add another playmaker to its receiving group this offseason, and they'll certainly get that from John Metchie from Alabama. He had over 2,000 yards in his final 2 years with the Crimson Tide. Expect to see him involved early and often in every game and really be a good blocker when they run the ball as well. Here, he catches the football and moves the chains.
He's going to float this one deep right side. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Houston. John Metchie with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Texans have moved out in front. Fairbairn good with the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. So a 75-yard scoring drive on just three plays. And it was all capped off by a John Metchie touchdown reception. Taking it about the one. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Colts come to the line, ready to start their next drive.
And the football changing hands here, and as this offense takes a field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for six.
And they're certainly hoping for more of the same, but the game plan, I doubt it'll just be a carbon copy of the last drive, because I think this offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook. They want to use that confidence to its advantage, while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next.
He's going up top for Taylor. Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
A lot of running backs in the passing game, they're just used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes. But this guy, they use him to stretch the field, don't they?
Stretched it right there, turned it into a really nice game. And the Colts are going to be set up with a first and goal as good running gets him down to about the 4-yard line.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
So three plays, already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Look at end zone, and he's got his man. It's Woods. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great effort there. His first NFL reception goes for six. And the Colts are an extra point away from evening this one up.
Although it's more commonplace now than at any other time in the NFL, it's still tough to think about throwing a rookie quarterback right into the fire week one. But guess what? He handled the fire awfully well and threw his first touchdown pass.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and we are tied at 14. Just a four-play drive that time. And a Jelani Woods touchdown catch capped things off. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And it'll come out to the 25 as King opts for the touchback. Now Houston's offense taking over again. And right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to seeing all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Staying on the ground with Mack. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. They'll try and run for this with Mack. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter. Mills now looks to throw on first down. And that's complete to Cooks. And some room to roam now. Touchdown, Houston. Brandon Cooks, 60 yards, and the Texans are in for six. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good, and the lead is now 21-14. So that drive, 4 plays, and it results in the Texans finding the end zone. This fielded right at the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here comes Jonathan Taylor and his teammates. They're behind in the first half here, CD, but it's not through any fault of their running back. He's had a strong start to this one.
And you're right about that, partner, because watching him play, you would think that his team is in the lead. He has been a lot of fun in this contest. Now let's see if they can actually make something happen and put more points on the board behind his efforts.
Yeah, I'm curious to see, Charles, if they can play complementary football and get that passing game going as well. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Running left, Taylor. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Sometimes that's a danger, putting that jumbo set out there. You just get a lot of bodies massed in one location. You could wind up with 18, 20, maybe even all 22 in the box, and there's nowhere to run the football.
This will be taken in by Michael Pittman, and he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. The previous play, they barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Now they pick up over 30 yards. So the big play gets them across midfield now for first and 10. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Running straight ahead, Taylor. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And that's caught left side by Mo Alie-Cox. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Play action. It's Ryan. To the right side and into the hands of the tight end, Granson. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 64 yards rushing for him in this first half as he is looking in mid-season form here in the opener. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Again, it's Taylor. He was brought down by Kabu Grugier-Hill. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jonathan Taylor, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Colts are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes, because that's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And it'll come out to the 25 as King opts for the touchback. Houston set to take over. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and 1 yard from the 34. Here's Mills. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Mills on first down. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Quiddy Pay getting in there and burying him behind the line.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face. Not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. Throwing on second and long. Mills. He dumps this off to Mack, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season.
It looks like we'll have to wait another week to get our first halftime report of the season as we move right along to the second half. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Colts taking the field again, running back Jonathan Taylor at center stage. He's toppled the century mark already, receiving the football, closing in on that on the ground, too. They've really had trouble handling him.
I think from what we've seen in this game, his success through the air has started to open things up for him on the ground, because now he's loosened up the defense, right? They've got to play just about every snap as if another receiver can get downfield on them, and he's been that receiver. Now they bring him back to the backfield. I think his yardage running the ball will increase as this one goes on.
Well, they might need to devote some extra attention to him, something just to stop the momentum he has. Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. It's a gain of 34.
You ask tight ends about their favorite routes to run, and surprisingly, this will pop up as one of their staples because they run so many routes in the middle of the field. How about this one? Starts downfield, bends it to the corner. Great touch on the football, and they turn that one into a big play.
First and 10, Taylor now. And down to the 41.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
There goes a deep ball, end zone. And oh, that would get a wide-up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone, probably should have been. Third down coming up. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. A give for Taylor running right side. And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. And before this fourth and three play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. From the right hash, this from 53. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and we will remain tied here in this third quarter. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter. They begin the drive on the ground with Mack. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. On second and 11 now, Mills. This ball caught by Mechie. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Mills to throw it. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Sacked by Yannick Ngakoue, the former Maryland Terp.
It's surprising that Indianapolis is Yannick Ngakoue's fifth team in the last four seasons. He's never had fewer than 8 sacks and 2 forced fumbles in a year, producing everywhere he's been.
Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. Throwing, Mills. This will be complete to Mechie. And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line.
Barney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cool. Of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go. Well, let's see who's faster.
They got to get to the 23 here on third. From the shotgun, it's Mills. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it but was not in bounds, incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gain something out of that drive.
And the Colts getting ready to go. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their...
And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. A big play there for Andy. 56 yards. Sometimes the one-handed catches are unnecessary, but he was trying to ward off the defender with the other, so maybe there that was just a good play.
So that tells you that not only do they imagine those types of catches, they actually work on them with defenders jostling them in order to keep their concentration and haul it in.
What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. On second down, it's Taylor. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 101 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in the season opener.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Off the play fake, here's Ryan. This will be caught just inside the 10. So the completion good for 7 there, and that'll bring up second down.
That's a good-looking play to me. The big tight end on a crossing route coming underneath, sometimes he can gain some serious momentum going forward, can't he?
Yeah, he can indeed, and pretty well executed there. They go play action with Ryan. Steps away to his left. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
Defensively, they rallied the troops to force fourth down after that 7-yard pickup back on first.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. So following the failed try on fourth down, we'll change ends and change possession. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Here's Cameron Johnston now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. Yard punt, 5 on the return. And the Colts will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That good for 22 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
They go to the ground again with Taylor. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Now a give to Taylor. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. And even 150 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game.
So, and he takes it in for a Colts score. Jonathan Taylor with now 3 week one touchdowns. And the Colts have taken a fourth quarter lead. He's got the hat trick now of rushing touchdowns. Also has his team the advantage.
And I'm looking at it two ways here. If I'm on defense, I don't care what they do now. I commit as many people as it takes to slowing him down running the football. Even if they want to hit me over the top on play action, I just don't let him beat me that way anymore. And if I'm him, I'm in the huddle calling the plays myself. I don't care what play call comes in. I tell my quarterback, guess what? You're handing it to me again.
And if I'm the quarterback, I'm saying, okay, that sounds good, right?
Smart quarterback.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And it'll come out to the 25 as King opts for the touchback. The Texans back out there and ready to go. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. And not a lot of success to be found there.
Oh, you got that right, partner, because if you're trying to make guys miss about 10 yards or so downfield, that's a pretty good play. But if you've got to do it in your own backfield, I consider that a problem. That doesn't work too well.
And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 5, and that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9. And they'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On 3rd down, here's Mills. Open man is Jordan, the tight end. And he is going to have a Texans 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And here we are in the 4th quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too. They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Mills. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the 4th quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. And they'll get this across the midfield stripe, but still winding up short of the 1st down. And that's good for a gain of 6, and that'll bring up 4th down. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. And they've got a 4th down now in a game that, to be honest, has been pretty much everything we could have asked for. They'll run for it. This is Mack. And I don't think he got there. He did not. They stop him a yard shy. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Colts are going to take over with a football. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They run once more with Taylor. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. This is Taylor, and he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Wow, 185 yards rushing for him now in the afternoon as he continues to put a hurt on this defense.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Spike comes now with just under 40 ticks left. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. They go down to a knee, and the new campaign off to a good start. It's a win here in week one. Rodrigo Blankenship with an important one. This will get the lead up to 7. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over.
Well, this was not just the opener of a brand new season, but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division, you knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.